a bond view on matters. Simon Michell from FIIG Live to the minute. Simon, welcome to you. It was kind of a month-end thematic on the UST space overnight, so yields pushing lower. You know, the potential now for higher rates over this year, what would say you to the current offering on data that lends support to that or otherwise? Look at Beige Book, consumer spending softening, wage growth moderate. You really kind of are being torn several directions.
Absolutely right, Carson. Good afternoon. And it really seems that data from the Beige Book is really moving away from where the Fed would like to see it. Mm-hmm. We've seen inflation drift down to a level around 1.5%. We know the Fed likes to see that around 2%. Seeing a very soft consumer as well, so we're not seeing a lot of consumer demand. So, you know, while the labour market looks very much where the Fed would like to see it, both in relation to growth and in relation to inflation, they're just finding those numbers just on the soft side. So while I continue to say that I think the June increase is locked in, I think what this means is, you know, we could see the rest of 2017 with no action by the Fed if this data continues to move away. So it's certainly not where the Fed would like to see it, and it's causing, as you see out in the space there, commentators to start to question or reassess the path forward for US rates.
There's the hue of deja vu about all this, is there not? I mean, Fed fund futures, to your point, now, yes, they've locked and loaded on June, but effectively then scrubbing anything else until the new year. So it does look eerily reminiscent. The only difference is the date so much as the tenor.
That's absolutely right. And I mean, you're just a little bit further down the year this year than we were last year. But look, it's interesting. If you look at the curve in the US as well, you know, the 2 year is only down about 10 basis points from its peak this year. But the 10 year is almost approaching 0.5% lower than the peak we've seen. So, you know, as we drift closer to interest rate increases, you're actually seeing those long term rates, as you suggest, moving lower. Mm-hmm. You'd expect them to move in the other direction. So, look, it's interesting times.
What's it like you to do to the A dollar? Would be your suspicion, say, you know, a 6 month call?
Yeah, well, this is interesting, isn't it? I mean, you know, if the Fed does stick to its path, then you would suggest that US rates are going to be above Australian rates very soon. At the margin at the moment, Aussie currently about 19 basis points above the US when you look at the 10-year. However, if we don't stick to that path, then obviously, you know, we could be in this tight, narrow range right through to the end of the year. Mm. Once those US rates do drift above the Aussie, you would expect to see quite a bit of a sell-off of the Aussie dollar as people reposition their exposure from Aussie bonds back into US and take advantage of that higher yield. So there are certainly some concerns. You're seeing commentators talking about the dollar, you know, drifting down even into the 50s. So that's certainly going to be something that people are watching on. A lot of volatility in the dollar today, as you've said already.
And is there a house consensus on whether it's time to sell the bond proxies? If we look at the equity space and those stocks that do have that, you know, the telco, the A-REIT theme, are you looking at more bias towards a sell on those now or hold tight?
Well, this is the interesting thing. We're actually seeing strong demand for both equities and bonds. So, you know, at the moment, I think people are having a bit of a bet each way. You know, they're taking their defensive allocation in bonds. We're still seeing demand pushing yields down there, but they're also happy to buy into to the equity market. We're still seeing strong growth there. At some point, those levels are going to reach a point where they're going to make a decision one way or another. Mm-hmm. You're either going to see rates, you know, drift up on a continued upward path and provide more return in the bond market, or you're going to see a correction in the equity market, which is going to bring people back from the bond market into the equity market. And that's what a lot of people are looking at the moment and trying to pick what time that's likely to occur, considering this volatility around that pathway forward for Fed rates.
ADP tonight, your expectation finally?
Yeah, look, it's interesting, isn't it? I don't know. I mean, I think, you know, I haven't had a close look at it. Mm-hmm. I might leave that for everyone else if I may.
And if anything, maybe look at the ISM gauge on jobs kind of coming through with that manufacturing release, because that tends to track, as we know more accurately, the NFP release, which is slated to round out this week.
Yeah, look, absolutely. And I think, you know, the thing there as well is that, you know, we're seeing a bit of activity around the labour market, but I think look at the underemployment, look at the wages growth. You know, until you start to see some activity in that, you know, people are going to be quite, not really willing to buy into this data at the moment.
Watch and sit from the sidelines in the stalls. Thanking you, Simon. Talk to you soon.
Thanks, Carson.
Simon Michell from FIIG. More.